wabarakatuh. Good morning to all. My name is Norazlan Zakaria. I'm a human. Probably soon you might not be surprised to have a robot here presenting. Or Gen-Z, probably we can employ Sophia. Makes things easy for me. Okay, let's go back to business. Encik Azizi, thank you very much for introducing my DF. Yes, speak a lot about our past and also present and also the core business of MIDF as well as our roles and responsibilities. I'll just go straight to what we have on offer. Okay, basically MIDF is part of MITI, we are an agency under MITI. So we provide financing for the industry, be it SME or non-SME. This is how we get our funds. We get our funds through MITI, SME Corp. They are now more in MITI. We have funds coming from Matrip, MIDA, and also we manage funds for Ministry of Finance as well as by Economic Corporation of Malaysia. Okay, just an overview of the products that we offer. We have factory mortgage financing in the form of term financing, Islamic. For your information, all our products are Shariah compliant, but we do consider non-Sharia compliant businesses, eh? No worries. For factory mortgage financing, we offer a margin of financing of up to 90% for purchase of factory land and buildings. And our financing tenure is also up to 25 years. For machinery financing as well as industrial hire purchase and leasing, our margin of financing for new machinery is up to 90%, and for reconditioned or used machine, we only finance up to 65%. Financing tenure is up to 7 years. But we have a special scheme for automation and modernization, which is meant for manufacturing companies, where we can, you know, offer a financing tenure of up to 10 years. So, as Azizi has mentioned that we provide, or we can, you know, consider giving grace period of up to 1 year, but under this automation and modernization scheme, we can actually give up to 3 years grace period. Okay, besides financing for capital expenditure, we also finance your working capital needs through this financing medium. Number one is sales revolving credit facility. Basically, these are all invoice financing. For sales revolving credit facility, these two, basically these three are revolving facilities. If you are familiar with only BA facility with the banks, it's almost similar to that. Okay, for sales revolving credit facility, it means we finance your post sales transactions. You have already delivered your services or your products to your clients. While waiting for the payment, we bridge the gap between the delivery and the payment. Okay, so maximum financing is up to 90% of the sales invoice value. If your sales price is 1 ringgit, we finance up to 90 cents, okay? And we provide, we can actually give you a tenor of a minimum 90 days, and you may extend it for another 6 days. So in total, you have about 150 days payment period, okay? Understand that? The other way, we can also you know, finance your purchases. Means those raw materials that you buy for you to process it to become your product. This is where we finance under the purchase revolving credit facility. And the amount of financing is actually up to 100% of the supplier's invoice. So if you, for example, you are a plastic bottle producer, you need to buy resins, you need to buy chemicals and whatnot. So for each ringgit that you buy, your raw material, you finance 100%. Yeah? And tenure is also up to 90 days with the option to extend it for another 60 days. For factoring, this is straightforward, 80% of your sales in invoice value. And the financing tenure is up to 180 days. But for factoring, this is only meant for those government jobs, government contracts that the company receives. Okay, as Azizi mentioned, these are the financing schemes that we manage. We have our small and medium enterprises scheme. We have a scheme for automation and modernization, which I'm going to put a little bit more emphasis. We have our financing scheme for services sector. We have a scheme for services capacity development. We have a scheme for services export. And we also have these two schemes under the emergency fund and also by tech, but I'm not going to actually go through this the two schemes. Yeah. Okay, let's go straight to the first scheme. This is the most sought after scheme because this scheme is basically meant for small and medium enterprises, be it a manufacturing company or a service company. So basically, it is to promote the development of SMEs, to assist existing and newly established enterprises to get financing for whatever reason, for capex requirement, for working capital requirement. So the maximum that you can get under this scheme is 5 million ringgit. Okay, it could be in fixed asset financing, working capital financing of up to 3 million. IT hardware, IT hardware and software, you can also finance up to 500,000. In total, the maximum we can give is 5 million ringgit. Okay. And this scheme is open for both manufacturing and also services company, except for insurance and financial services companies. And this is the scheme that we are now promoting. And this is in line with the government's effort to encourage SMEs to go for automation. In line with the Industry 4.0 drive. So basically, this scheme is to assist manufacturing companies to automate and modernize the processes. Minimize dependence on labor and upgrade production capability and capacity. Okay, unlike other schemes that we have, we can actually finance up to 20 million per application under this scheme. And the beauty about this scheme is it is open for both SMEs and non-SMEs. But non-SMEs, you have to pay a bit more. For SMEs, our interest rate is 4%. For non-SMEs, it's 5%. 4% is based on yearly rest reducing balance method. Irrespective of whatever product facilities that we have, all are based on reducing balance method. So if you compare us with the market, if you look at industrial high purchase, market will probably charge you say 4 or 5% flat rate. Ours is still 4% reducing balance. So the effective rate, if you compare, we are so much lower than the market. Okay? And this scheme is only meant for manufacturing. So these are the criteria that the company need to establish or demonstrate to be eligible for this scheme. Number one, automation and modernization of processes. It means from a normal process of having so many human to do the work, now you upgrade it, you know, to a more modernized and automated process by having robots and automation around. Okay. Okay. Basically, these are things that we finance the automation. So under the automation scheme, we can also actually finance your legal fees. Yeah? This includes the legal fees excluding the stamping fees and disbursement batana. Okay, but this is only applicable for SMEs. We also finance the consultation fees for projects undertaken by companies for the purpose of business operations related to automation. So it is not only for the financing of the machines that you buy, that also includes consultancy fees. Okay? But this is also applicable for SMEs. So it covers the whole range of facilities, including term financing, working capital financing, purchase rewarding, and other investment. And we also finance your requirement for IT equipment, hardware, and software. Okay? So basically, it covers just everything. Now, these are the features which I've actually explained just now. I'm going to skip this. Okay. I believe when we talk about robotics and automation, we are talking about manufacturing, right? But how many of you are in the services industry? I mean, you may have a player. Some of you may have a group of companies, but I'll go through it anyway. Okay, this scheme is meant for services sector, right? To assist companies, enterprises in the services sector to expand their services into higher value-added activities. To assist the companies to improve their productivity and efficiency in service delivery, and also to provide financing assistance for new startup companies and enterprises, okay, to create new services and technology. Maximum financing 5 million, 4% for SMEs, 5% for non-SMEs, and we basically cover every sector of the services industry except for insurance, financial services, utilities, and construction. So interesting, huh? Okay. Under this scheme, there are four types of financing that we can give. Term financing for ICT, hardware and software, up to 1 million. Term financing for machinery, equipment, motor vehicle, up to 5 million. Revolving facility, up to 3 million. And working capital financing for advertising and promotion costs. Okay. So number 3 and 4, it is on a sharing basis. This working capital for advertising and promotion is only up to 500,000 rupiah. And under this scheme, you may not be worried, you know, to come up with a security, because when you deal with banks, especially for working capital financing, they will normally ask for a tangible security. It could be landed property, it could be a form of, say, fixed deposits. Okay, here we have basically collaborate with Syarikat Jaminan Pembiayaan Perumahan or insurance SJPP, where they can cover up to 70% of the loan amount. So if you want to borrow 1 million rupiah, SJPP will cover 700,000, 300,000, comes from the company. Okay? But to enjoy this guarantee, there is a fee that you have to pay, an annual fee that you pay to SGBP of 1% per annum. Okay? On top of the 4% or 5% that we charge. Alright, this is another scheme that we have for services capacity development and services industry to provide financial assistance to local service providers to withstand the competition and strengthen internal competitiveness. Okay? This is to get those companies, especially those in healthcare, you know, in professional services, because now we are opening up our market to foreign competitors. So this is the facilities, the scheme to help them to take up the challenge, yeah? To be competitive. Our interest rate is still 4% for SMEs and 5% for non-SMEs. And this is spent only for services sector, yeah? And this is the latest scheme that we have to assist Malaysian service providers to undertake activities to expand and venture into international markets. So those of you who have already secured contracts overseas, this is the scheme that you should look for. And the interest rate is only 2% there. Okay, maximum of 5 million. There are things that we can actually finance under this scheme. Majid provides grants under the Services Export Fund. We provide the financing. Okay, so some expenses, it has to be applied under grants. Some expenses will be under money financing. These are the things that we finance. We finance the cost of preparation of project proposals for overseas projects up to $2 million. Okay, when you want to prepare your proposal paper, you need to engage professionals, right? So you have to pay. So you can come to us and we can consider giving you financing up to $2 million. And we also, you know, provide financing for you to pay the bank guarantee fee. Yeah? We don't provide the bank guarantee facility, but you must already have a bank guarantee line with the bank. So for you to issue the bank guarantee, you must pay a fee to the bank. That fee, MRF can finance up to 5 million. And we can also finance the collateral for the issuance of the bank guarantee or performance bond for you to give it to the bank of up to 5 million. You see, when you want to have a bank guarantee facility, normally they will ask for security, right? We will provide this security. And we also, you know, provide financing for you to set up your overseas office up to 150,000 ringgit. But this company must already have been granted the grant up to 50% from Madrid for setting up of the overseas office for the initial 12 months period. Okay. So in order for you to be eligible for this financing, you must be registered with Matrix, okay, and we also finance mobilization cost of up to 5 million ringgit. Okay, these are funds that we also have, but I'm not going to discuss this. Okay, other than that, I'm going to basically share how to apply for a loan with MIDF. Basically, you must be a company registered in Malaysia. And the minimum local shareholding is 60%. Okay? Except for the automation and modernization scheme, the minimum local shareholding is 51%. And other schemes, 60%. You must have a valid premises or business license. Some facilities schemes are only meant for SMEs, such as the soft financing scheme for SMEs and also the emergency fund. The others are open for both SMEs and non-SMEs. Okay. We also have this guarantee scheme, as I mentioned, under the soft loan scheme for service sector, where we try to assist SMEs in all sectors to gain access to financing from respecting financial institutions. So under this scheme, we get SGPP to provide the guarantee. Okay. So these are the criteria for a company to have access to the guarantee. It is similar, or it is basically the same thing as the eligibility criteria for the facilities or the schemes that we offer. Must be a company incorporated in Malaysia, at least 51% shares held by Malaysians. And the most important thing is, shareholders fund must not be more than 20 million. Then you are eligible for the 70% maximum guarantee fee, but subject to 1% guarantee fee payable upfront. Basically, these are the schemes, these are the guarantee scheme that SGPP provides. Under for automation process guarantee scheme, services sector guarantee scheme, working capital guarantee scheme, working capital guarantee scheme for startup, as Aziz mentioned, we also provide financing for startup companies, as well as intellectual property guarantee scheme. I believe GSD has touch on this. Now, okay, the way we detail this, first, we would do this preliminary evaluation. Okay, so when you come to us, you say that you need financing. So we will discuss. We need these few documents for us to review your financials and structure the financing, and also to make advice or comments on your financial position. We need to see your audited accounts. We need to see your latest management accounts. We need to have to see that you really have a license or business premises on your business and your premises, your bank statements, surely your statutory company documents, company profile, and your quotations. Okay. So normally when we engage, when we discuss, we will tell you, okay, based on the company's financial position, based on the amount of financing that you require, and whether or not your requirement suits the objective of the specific scheme, you're okay to apply. If not, then we tell you, okay, your financing, your financial position may not be favorable now, but we also advise you, probably you should do this for you to be eligible for the financing in the near future. Okay? So once we are okay with this, then you will submit your form application. We will give you the application form details out the documents and information that you need to provide. Once you get the information, the documents and information ready and complete, you submit it to us. Okay, then only we will start the formal process of reviewing and getting the necessary approval. Okay? Okay, we are not a big setup. you only have 5 so-called regional branches. I'm from the central region. This is where our HQ is in Jalan Raja Julian, Kuala Lumpur. We have a branch in Penang Island. We have one in Kota Baru. We have one in Johor Bahru, Kuching, and also in Kuala Lumpur. So you can, you know, look us in the social media. We are in the LinkedIn. We are in the Twitter. You can find us in Facebook, and this is our website. Our website will basically, you know, you can get all information about our products, facilities, social services in our website. Okay, these are the addresses. I mean, if you need to get more information about where we are, what we do, who we are, you can always contact me. We have a booth outside. We'll be here until 2 p.m. You can get our business card, you can communicate through emails, through WhatsApp, or WhatsApp. We are happy to assist. That's the end of my presentation. I think we still have time, limited time for some Q&As if you wish to. Or not. If not, then probably you can, you know, go to our booth. Any questions? Yes, sir. This is part of the documents and information that we require. But for a start, the initial discussion, we need this.
If I got 5 years of
it, then you know, if you are new startup or you start with, you just establish for 1 year, then 1 year audited account is sufficient. It's okay, it's okay. Because we do finance newly startup companies. And for information, for newly startup companies, to enjoy the guarantee from the CDP, you must be at least in operation for 6 months. So 6 months to 2 years is deemed as a newly startup company. Okay? Any other questions? If yes, thanks. Right. What kind of the security that you want to provide? Okay. There are two types of financing. One is capex. You buy machines. When you buy machines, the machine itself becomes a school. So automatically you don't need to provide any other tangible security. So the security will be 70% from the GDP, and the machine we take as security. But for working capital, because you don't have any other tangible security unless we structure it together with the equipment financing. If it is a standalone working capital financing, then we have to still come up with the 30% security in the form of fixed deposit. So kalau 1 million facility, then tidak ada target. It could be more or less up to 30% lah. That's nice. Okay, alright. Borrowing to pay up capital is 1-to-1. So if your shareholders, we talk about shareholders fund lah. Not pira capital. Shareholders fund means your pira plus your retained earnings and probably your reserves. Huh? So it's 1-to-1. So if you have 1 million in your shareholders fund, we can only give 1 million. But for a new startup, normally what we do is we can't actually finance you up to 90%. But what we can do is, you know, you put inside the company 50%, then we finance the remaining 50%. So if your total investment is 1 million, okay, so you must come up with that 500,000, we finance you with the remaining 500,000. But it will be, you know, depends on the things that we can finance that. We cannot finance your general working capital requirement. Contohnya gaji, we can finance. Things like that, we can consider. Things like renovation, raw materials, that one we can finance. Any other questions? Training. Okay. Okay. Under automation itu boleh. Under automation itu boleh. Yeah. System integrated ni normally kita just finance dia punya the equipment and the software sahaja. Demand video. But for automation video, because whatever that comes under for you to complete the automation, that includes training and everything can be included. Yes. Forms, banner, forms. Sir, sim. For SMEs, non-SMEs is 5%. Any more question? Yes? Good, tak apa ya? Okay, assuming that you already get the SMEP guarantee lah. Say for 1 million, you dapat guarantee for 1 million lah. So 1% is, berapa? 10,000 lah. So that 10,000 must be before SCBP issue the guarantee. Yeah. Yes. Any questions? The no more, I mean, if you need to know more, can always come and, you know, talk to us outside lah. With that, I end my presentation and I wish to thank everybody here for listening. And thank you very much.